Well, it's perhaps a cliche to suggest that rugby is a game of inches. Now, as a kicking coach, it's definitely my responsibility to develop technically the skills of the kickers that I work with. But more than that, it's a responsibility to show them and teach them the game awareness, the ability to find the inches that are going to allow their team the advantages they need to get a roll on top of the opposition. Now, when it comes to line kicking, I think line kicking are the easiest inches or meters or yards that we can find in a game. Now, it's what we call a self-paced skill. You're doing it in your own time. So if you have a really good or well-developed system and process, and you understand where you are on the field in terms of your range, then I think you're better set up to provide a really good platform for your team. So in this video, we're going to talk somewhat about the two different mindsets with line kicking. One, of course, is the safety mentality. The safety mentality is the player or the coach that looks to just get the ball out for a safe restart. And the other is, of course, the positive mindset. And we are talking about positive line kicking today. And I'm referring there to looking for optimal or maximal range or distance, because we're looking to gain as much as we can, certainly if we're exiting our own territory. Aside from giving ourselves a really good platform for our restart, it's very much a psychology changer as well. So we'll look at the system and technique that's required for optimal distance, and we'll also look at factoring in a formula for you when you're on the field to help you with your range as well. So when it comes to practicing our line kicking, I hope that you're on my wavelength in considering quality over quantity. Now, the reason why I say this is we just cannot afford, and there's certainly not enough time in the week, let alone to have sessions where we don't have any structured outcome. We need to make sure that we're giving ourselves the best opportunity to learn and to retain the information. But when we look at developing a system and a process to kick by, then there's definitely some key ingredients that we need to work on to allow us to be able to extend our range as a line kicker. Now, those ingredients, we'll just work on three today. The first one is we need to look at really good transfer of weight. Now, transfer of weight is taking the energy that's built up within the body's movement and transferring it through the kick. And what that means is that we're able to generally optimize our distance and our range, but certainly if we're kicking through the line of the ball, then that allows us to be able to gain our accuracy and certainly to maintain our control over the ball. The other one is impact line. We're going to look at the line that is formed or should be formed between the path of the knee, the foot, and the apex of the ball, again to maximize our opportunity of getting a really nice sweet contact through the line. And of course, before all that takes place, you need to make sure that our kicking system is activated and that we're kicking with our leg switched on. We'll talk a little bit more about that analogy shortly. So those three things are we need to switch the leg on, we need to form an impact line, and we certainly need to make sure that we're kicking with transfer of weight.
Nice kick by Hernandez.
I think the best way for us to look at positive line kicking, certainly the lesson that you've had today and the information that's been brought to you, we need to look at it as a framework to kick within. Now, as you can see, I have a perfectly sunny and rather warm day without any wind and certainly no rain in sight. So I've spoken to you about a formula that we should use for ourselves, and again, you need to know your range right now, right this minute, before you're able to then develop and improve it. But given these conditions here are somewhat perfect, I understand depending on what part of the world that you coach or play, then there are going to be conditions that I'm familiar with that will change your view on the formula. And I guess I'm referring to freezing cold, where you might not be able to feel your feet as well as what we can here today. We certainly have rain that would affect your grip on the ball. And the feeling of heaviness that can come from those conditions as well. Not everyone's able to play on a pitch that's fully grassed like this, I understand. So where I talk about 30 or 40 metre gain is certainly a perfect world, but I believe it is more than achievable. But given your context, your conditions and circumstances, you might need to make those necessary adjustments. But the technique and the system that you've seen today will serve you regardless of what level you play or coach, and certainly what conditions are presented to you. In fact, they're going to help you in a much better way than kicking without any system or process would. So I hope that's been a help to you. We've spoken today about positive line kicking. Remember, it's all about kick volume, getting some practice, but more than just the quantity of practice, we need to make sure that we have the quality. So set yourself your structure, work on your system, your process, and your outcomes, and challenge yourself. Good luck. I hope to see you soon.